Right, you guys see this? I'm by the beach. You see how the homes are set up. It can also, you know, be like this in suburban neighborhoods, similar to this. What you have to know and have to realize is that if you live in a place like that, where the homes are designed that way, wall to wall, just access to each other, fencing, and your dog is out there free without you there, you're setting them up to be not aggressive necessarily, but like a guard dog, which could make them become aggressive, not just an alert dog, but territorial. And then that can lead to aggression if it's not really looked at closely. Now, it's very possible that some of you out there, you have dogs that just don't have it in them, or they just do a little bit of alert barking and you tell them to knock it off and they stop. That is more temperament, genetics. It just depends. It really depends on the dog. I came across a golden retriever that jumped on the fence, because they're low fences, and was excitedly barking at me. Nobody was in sight, but it was definitely alert and excitement. I could have probably reached in the fence and or reached on top of the fence and pet the golden retriever. I didn't, but I bet a bunch of people do. That dog is sweet and it's just alert barking, and it did stop. When I ignored it and kept walking, it stopped. That's temperament, that's genetics, versus a dog that has a very strong instinct to guard, to be territorial. Sometimes that's all it is, and it goes and it's somebody comes in, doesn't escalate, but a lot of times it escalates if you don't work on it, and then you can't have guests over. Or you have to put your dog away when you have guests over, which is perfectly fine. I'm just trying to let you guys know that's the reality of these types of neighborhoods, these types of areas. And just keep that in mind when you're fed up with your dog and your dog's behavior. If you're giving them free roam of your property without supervision from the humans, you are setting them up to potentially be territorial and guard, period. So there's no amount of training that might curb that. It's more about how you are communicating your environment to your dog, and free roaming with nobody there to help the dog work through emotions is confusing if you don't want a dog that barks and guards and is territorial.